And they,
I mean, they didn't scare me. I mean, I don't know the feeling that I was having.
What did they look like? I mean, were they people? I mean, you're telling me you're seeing figures. I mean, you actually saw this?
Well, what I, that's the point, is that when you see something like this that is so different than your normal reality, it's like, I can't really be seeing this. So you have all this currently of doubt about whether or not it's really happening. Yeah. You don't see anybody else talking, going on the street talking about images of these eyes, these owls, these things that come at you.
I don't know, Billy. It's just hard for me to think about in general. It's just so unreal to me. It's so fringe, and I want to believe you.
That's the point. I want to believe it.
I just really have a hard time with it, really. I mean,
well, of course. It should be from this point of view.
Yeah.
I mean, you don't know whether or not you're going crazy or whether or not you're delusional or whether or not it's really going on. And if it's really going on, then how do you deal with it? What is it you can do about it? Nothing.
I mean, look, obviously you're not crazy. Maybe you should go to, a professional or something. I'm not saying you're crazy. You know, all kinds of people go all kinds of places to professionals.
Right. How much does that cost? Where do you get it?
Who knows?
Who do you call? 911, excuse me, I like to talk to a psychiatrist.
Well, maybe it's something you don't totally understand.
Pardon?
But I see a lack of evidence and proof that it's actually happening here. For myself, personally.
Exactly.
Maybe I haven't looked into it. Maybe that's something I should think about. I want you to think about some of the alternatives that could be. Maybe there's a rational, safe explanation for what's going on, and it's nothing more than you not working, you being under lots of stress, and having bad dreams.
I would love for that to just be what it is. I mean, I would love to wake up and say, that was a dream. Oh, God, that's just a dream.
Speaking of dreams, I need to get home and have some sweet dreams, I hope, of my own, and you need some rest and get some good sleep.
Oh, see, that's the point, man. You get so wrapped up in your own personal shit. Forget, oh, yeah, I'm still here with me.
You know, I'm gonna be with you on this. I'm not going to run and hide and try to see this through, you know.
Well,
I don't know. Maybe you'll make a big mistake.
Yeah, really.
Look,
bring your video.
I'll give you a call tomorrow. All
right.
Okay, and I'll check in on you.
All right.
Bill. Night.
Good night.
I was let go on a medical discharge about a week ago, and I've kind of been running across the country. Man, I don't know where to start. They'll triangulate on the position really, really soon.
Well, you can't spend a lot of time on the phone, so give us something quick.
Okay. What we're thinking of as aliens are they're extra-dimensional beings that an earlier precursor of the space program made contact with. They are not what they claim to be. They have infiltrated a lot of aspects of military establishment, particularly the Area 51. The disasters that are coming, the government knows about them, and there's a lot of safe areas in this world that they could begin moving the population to now, Art.
So they're not doing anything.
They are not. They want the major population centers wiped out so that the few that are left will be more easily controllable.